Relax and take notes.
Watch close and see what life throw at me. Bible studies, counting money, watching Dave Ramsey. Back from California trying to make my girl happy. Still in the hood, bandos like Adam's family. Yeah, but I'm feeling like Gary V. ADHD got me on TV. Yeah, now ADHD, HD. Ooh wee, you can hear me clearly. 2-3, Matt Damon making movies. Rich host elegance, but tracks stay spooky. Yeah, cause these films like Paramount. Don't worry my whereabouts. Corny rappers point them out. Fiends for the large amounts. Always bring the starters out. Homies on the east and the west, all stars announced. Crowds like the derby, got them screaming like a Vladimir. Swing for the stars, baseballs in the stratospheres. Y'all just imagineers, I build pioneers. Trophies on the boat, going viral like the Buccaneers. I've shed plenty tears and I've spent many years. Y'all just tell stories, y'all sounding like the Musketeers. Feeling like 100 years, I've seen too many peers come and go. Cause we ain't have no common goals. Adios, then they wonder why I gotta go. Another soul asked why they gotta know. Rich souls, elegance, dark skin, melanin. Early morning melons in proteins and vitamins. RPL to residents, Richie Ray for president. Speeches come heaven.
We back at it again, RPL TV. Look, that's one of my favorite producers right there, Alchemist alongside Hit-Boy. Yo, it's crazy here, man. Yeah, that's dope, man. Look, man, RPL TV, y'all know what time it is. We're going to do something special because today I have some good news for y'all. Your boy got to perform with ASAP Rocky. Yo, no lie, man, it was amazing time. Went to Rolling Loud, shout out Suave. Go check out the vlog. We just put that out, and that one's just explains everything, man. But I'm going to go ahead and show y'all on this episode what we got going on. So we're going to talk about the story with ASAP. Also have something going on the internet that I found, which was my boy Richie. Yeah, no lie, his name is Richie. He's a barber too. This is crazy. Now he's a barber. If you go check him out, he's also doing a podcast out, and we'll get into that, man. But his story and what he has going on and how he's exploding on the internet is crazy. Not only that, there's just so many updates even with my music. I got first and the 15th. Y'all already know what we're doing. It's a song every single month. Matter of fact, that's two songs every month because we're doing it on payday, baby. First and the 15th payday. Y'all already know what it is. Ritual Productions is going to drop videos. RPL TV, we're going to have it all set up like we've been. Go check out Comatose. Go check out Young Beretta. I mean, I got even freestyles. I got music videos. I stacked on top of each other when it comes to my mixtape, The World Is Yours. So I'm always going to mention that because that's one of my like pivots in my music career, is like doing this mixtape and doing a video for every single song. And it's just insane. If you see 4K quality, Rich Show Productions, just yo, this is another level. Shout out to my big brother Anthony. You know, he's always taking care of the filming and the droning, and that's my dog right there. So I get behind on the boards and I edit. Go check that out. But yo, ASAP Rocky, Rolling Loud, Suave and Friends, RPL TV. We went out there. We went to New York City. We went to LA, and now we're in Miami. It was crazy. It was just such a. It was just such a. How do you say, an experience that came out of nowhere, and I think that's the best, like surprises and stuff. And quick story, man, I'm out in Miami with Suave. We're getting it done. He buys me the first day of Friday Rolling Loud tickets, and we're at it, man. First day was dope. Ice Spice comes out as soon as we get there. Matter of fact, before we got there, we're Essential C drops the freestyle with Drake. We get there, she's performing, that's cool. Then later towards the night, shout out yeah, Lil Yachty. That was I never seen him live. That was an amazing performance. And then Playboi Carti at the end, which you know how Rolling Loud gets with Playboi Carti, right? Yo, peep, dope. Ate food, seafood diet. Again, go check out the vlog on Suave and Friends. We get done with the first day. It's dope. And on the vlog, you get 1, 2, and 3 all the days, right? First day, it's done. I think next morning, the whole time I'm there, I'm trying to hit up my boy Prince, aka another guy named Rich, Richard. Yo, it's crazy, man. Richie's in the building. We got Richard, Richie the barber, and RPL TV, Richie Ray. Look, man. So Rich hits me up. Richard, aka I'm gonna call him Prince. We call him Prince. He's like acting right now. He's going back and forth for Atlanta, doing Tyler Perry stuff. He's on Hulu and different stuff like that. It's dope. I'm trying to holler at him. I've seen him before when I went out to Miami. Yo, where you at? Instagramming him, trying to see what's good. I'm like, this guy's not getting back. He's probably super busy. It's Rolling Loud weekend. He probably don't even, like, he's probably, his phone's blowing up out of nowhere. He texts me, hey, man, you want to perform with ASAP Rocky on stage? just hit up my homegirl. Well, it's not his homegirl, but he said hit up my girl here. Headshot, height, weight, paragraph or something about you, email, phone number. They'll get back to you. Boom, out of nowhere, man. 5 minutes later, I get an email. I'm verified. This whole time, I'm thinking this is a spam. Because my boy texts me, and he's cool. I'm not saying he's fake. Maybe he's like account got hacked, or I don't know. Someone just, maybe he's just shooting out spams, and it got to me. I don't know. 5 minutes later, I get an email. And then the reason why I emailed the lady is because there was a typo in my boy's text. So I was like, wow, you know, peep this. This is like not even written well. Like he has a typo in it, right? That's how you know when it's a real text. So I hit him up, get on the phone. Long story short, chop it up with the lady that he's working with. Really cool, real sweet lady. And boom, she tells me, she breaks it down. You're going to be doing a rehearsals at night, like 12 in the morning to like 3 in the morning. And once that's over, you're going to meet the next, that same day, following day at 5 p.m. at the buses. They're going to go ahead and take you into Rolling Loud backstage. Yo, I'm still kind of not paranoid. I'm still not sure at this point. Long story short, man, the time comes. I'm hitting on my boy Creative Angel to slide. Suave got all three he got all 3 days, so he's like, I'm just going to enjoy all 3 days. Like, he paid a bunch of money for it. And on top of that, it was just like, I wasn't sure yet. I don't know, man. I had to be there. Yo, show up to the buses, right? We had a destination point we had to meet. My boy Creative Angels pops up out of there. Boom, what the heck happened? Yo, now we got Orlando people in the building. I'm like, this is dope. I got people from Orlando here. Savi's here, right? My boy, the next day, my boy Scott shows up. Anyways, I'm jumping too far. Rehearsals, jump on the bus, go into Rolling Loud. While it just ended, we're in the back. Boom, ASAP Rocky comes through. I'm like, yo, ASAP Rocky's in the joint, bro. Comes in. He breaks down basically what everybody told us. Like, yo, what we're wearing. And at this point, we're kind of psyched. You know, he came in. We started clapping. We were hyped. He was like, you know, thanks for coming last minute. This is a last minute idea because this is actually inspired off of the film that he directed with Beats. Go check out the Beats commercial. That's where he does the inspiration of the white bandana with the white shirt. And that's where he's able to, like, direct his own video. It was an amazing video. And he did it for Beats, which is a big company. Then he wanted to react the same thing on Miami Rolling Loud, and he hit me up. I mean, you know, he didn't hit me up, but you know, he was able to get in contact with people that knew me, and it's just crazy. Yo, I'm there, he's explaining everything. Yo, funny story about this, man. It's so funny, bro. ASAP Rocky, he's showing us how to put the bandana on. I promise, he's in the room putting the bandana on. He's like halfway trying to show us like the vision, what we're doing. And he's like putting it on, and he can't, like, he just, I don't know, at that point, he's just annoyed he can't put it on. He's like, yo, forget this. He takes it off and like gets somebody that was there to put it on. It was just funny because, you know, you're sitting around, you're one of your favorite artists, and you're like, oh, snap, you're just paying attention to his move, every move kind of thing. Like, dang, this is crazy. Am I going to get this moment back? And he does something funny like that. I thought it was hilarious. Feel like a son I would have done, right? Just be like, yo, someone else do this. That's exactly what he did. It was so funny. Yo, long story short, man, we do rehearsals. We barely really did rehearsals. He just told us on the stage where we're going to be. We got our white jeans. I mean, our white shirt, blue jeans, white shoes. We were ready for the ASAP Rocky performance. Boom. The next day, same thing. Buses get on, go to the same spot. And we're in there. We're in the cut. We're waiting. We wait a good long time. Lil Uzi Vert's going, you know, he's crazy. Fireworks are exploding. I'm like, this is wild. Then we go to the back. Not going to lie, I see a Rocky Migos. I mean, not ASAP, but just the whole set design, everything. We had to wait really long. We're in the back, man. They're like, yo, you're just going to run into the middle, to the mosh pit. You're going to go nuts. I'm like, no way. So the anticipation is wild, man. Finally, we get there. Boom, man. The gate opens up. ASAP Rocky shuts down the lights. The helicopter sound comes on. The lights everywhere. They're like, yo, where's ASAP Rocky? We're running. Yo, we're giving dap and stuff to the people in the crowd. They're sticking their hands out like we're superstars. We got the bandanas on. Nobody could really, you know, nobody could see or tell us, who we are. So we're going nuts. Try not to die, too, because we didn't want to suffocate under the mask. But it was cool, man, standing on the railings with the crowd, being like, yo, cheering, and just like the crowd holding on to you, making sure you're not gonna fall, like just kind of loving on you, everyone having a good time, you know. And it was safe, it wasn't crazy. They were giving out water and stuff, and certain people, you know, it does get real dangerous. I was saying Rolling Loud, when you're in the front and you're just like hanging out in these big crowds, it's like nobody's trying to necessarily like hurt anyone. It's just you're, if there's no seats, there's just a big old crowd, it's insane. It could be really hectic, and it was crazy, man. But man, it was awesome, man. And like, that's what happens when you're in the right place at the right time, making good connections, trying your best to grind. It's not really about quality sometimes. I've been learning that it is about, right now in 2023, they just want quantity, and that it's not necessarily quantity. What it is, it's consistency. And I think quality, it like definitely wins over quantity in the long term and the longevity of it. But in the time that we're in, it's just a lot of like consistencies that don't seem to feel like they're working, because sometimes what it is those times being so consistent and putting out quantity, I know you're paying attention to your art, but you'll get the quality as you put out. You know what I mean? If you're not shy and not being afraid of what the world has, that's what happens. And I feel like I've been doing that for so long, trying. I'm still going as hard as I can to keep continue that battle of like that uphill battle of becoming an artist in 2023. You know, and also just the podcast that I have going on. It's a lot, but stay consistent, get around the right people. Take chances. You know, I'm not performing, man, with ASAP Rocky, but I got the experience of seeing the crowd and what it's like being with ASAP in the room twice. You know, we saw him the second night. He came through with the pearls in his head. I wanted to wrap this up. This is going to be really cool. This last piece right here, man. Richie the Barber, what's good, man? Where you at? This is RPL TV podcast. You know, congratulations. I just want to share this message with Richie the Barber specifically. If you don't know who he is, he's a barber in LA. I believe it's California specifically. I mean, it's in California. I'm not sure where specifically, but he just gave his life to Christ. I thought that was amazing. But dude, before you look this guy up, I want to tell you something, man. Two quick stories real quick, and one is relatable and one might not be so relatable because this is not the type of environment you grew in. I remember, man, quick story about, you know, how I came to Christ and stuff. At 15 years old, I went to jail, man. I didn't really go to jail. It was more like a kind of place before you go to jail. So I'm not going to sit here and say it was some crazy thing. But, you know, 15 years old, I got handcuffed. I got thrown on the ground. I was actually trying to take marijuana out of my pocket and throw it away before the cops came up to me. And they thought I was grabbing a weapon. So things could have got more worse. So things could have got worse. But the situation was that when I was 15 years old, man, you know, I felt dumb, you know, being in the back of a cop car. I was 15. I just had weed on me. The cops thought we were stealing cars, but we were just walking through the parking lot to try to like cut faster to go to the movie theater. We were like in a plaza, man. We had no business stealing cars, especially with the lights on. There's like tons of people outside. It was dumb. I feel like they were really just picking on us, but I understand. At the same time, things like that probably do happen around there. Long story short, man, just felt like a clown, man. Certain things in my life, I just felt real, like, you know, just felt dumb and embarrassed in front of my parents. And I didn't mean to go on a downhill from the ASAP Rocky story, but I wanted to make a good point. And then, you know, the second story where I felt just like, you know, you just feel really horrible. You just feel like a total clown about everything. And you're just like, dang, what did I do? Like, this is, you have no control of, like, you kind of have to make up for your mistakes. Losing your job, that might be more relatable. You know, I remember doing working for the city, and I had done some. I remember taking the rental car to my house, and they didn't like that. And I had stayed overnight, drove back to work because I didn't have a car. But they just weren't really with it. I don't know. It was just a real strict policy not to bring it home, which I understand. But it was just overnight, right? Long story short, I lose my job, and I felt dumb. You know, you feel horrible. It was a good job working for Orange County, and you lose it, and you feel like a total clown, man. And I wanted to tell y'all, there's a lot of things in your life and things that you've done, you know, artists and creators and people trying to move on in business. This is not a time to be blaming yourself, man, especially when it comes to God. Y'all know on this channel, I try to spread God's love. You know, God loves you. You know, even here in the comfort of RPL TV, if you're watching my videos, my podcast, I just want to encourage people, man. God, that's what God has done in my life. He has encouraged me. He has, like, took me out of that state of mind of, like, blaming myself. And people always say, like, oh, can God even love me? Can God save me? Does God even want to talk to me? Does he even know the things that I've done? It's like, well, yeah, we all know that God is, you know, almighty. He sees what we've done as humans. But I understand that a lot of people are afraid of God, you know, in that sense. Look at what I've done, my past, and things that people don't know, probably will never know. And I just want to come here to tell you, man, those mistakes I made in my life, they might not be like as big as yours or catastrophic, but I felt like a clown. I felt dumb at 15 years old, you know, in front of my parents. Just felt like, man, this is the worst thing ever, losing my job and just being real hectic. And, you know, I do feel guilty. There's certain things where you know you're doing wrong and you still do wrong. And so with all that being said, man, Richie the Barber gave his life to Jesus Christ. Some of y'all, it'll probably come off funny. It's pretty crazy, man. And he knows it's crazy. But Richie the Barber actually had surgery on him. And Richie the Barber actually looks like a clown. And so I wanted to tell you that to not be funny. Like, I know it sounds funny. Richie's actually a character himself. Go check him out. They're actually really funny. But the fact that this guy identified himself as a clown for his entire life, or not entire life, for a significant moment in his life, and still looks like a clown, embraces that, and people are like really worried about what they've done and who they are. And it's so funny that no matter where he goes, he'll be a clown. And it blows my mind sometimes, and God laughs at me And maybe it is funny thinking about a guy last time he goes, Richie, I could even save a clown. And he's always going to look that way. This is what he chooses. Some people are always going to be like, this is dumb. And look at him being saved. And he's a Christian. And he looks like a clown. And I just want to tell somebody out there, if you really think that your problems are that big, and you feel like you felt like a clown, and there's moments where you felt horrible, that I'm not even going to make a big deal out of it. That's nothing to God, man. I wanted to share a scripture with you one moment that even God could even save a clown. And to me, it's just like literally he identifies himself as a clown, and now he wants to proclaim Jesus Christ. And that's just, I'm not going to judge him. He actually is trying to do his podcast, and he's doing different things, and, you know, he's being funny and stuff. But the fact that he wants to like do certain things for Christ, you know, and I pray for my brother that he keeps doing what he's doing, like that God can even look at him and be like, I'm not even disgraced of you. The whole world, even now that he's a Christian, don't even matter to some people. Even the Christians watching this might still make fun of him and be like, yo, he's a clown. Yeah, God can even save a clown. So I want to tell you, when you feel bad for yourself and you're beating yourself up, Psalms 103, 10-11 says, he does not deal with us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his steadfast love towards those who fear him. And to me, that's powerful. He does not deal with us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our iniquities. For as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his steadfast love towards those who fear him. Man, woo, I'm sweating. Look, man, this scripture is crazy, man. Because I feel like in my spirit, I don't like to preach too much on God's word. I really feel God's love when I understand what it says, that he's gonna, that for as high as the heavens are above the earth, so great is his love towards us, that he does not deal with us according to what we've done. He does not repay you according to what you've done. The world we live in, that's what they do. They repay us according to what we do. Let's start with work. They pay you for what you do. When you're dealing with your spouse or dealing with relationships, some people are petty and want to go back at you. They're repaying you. It's normal. Your brother, your sister, you grew up teasing each other. You hit them, they hit you. You play around, wrestle. They repay you for what you've done to them. And God's saying here that he does not do that. He does not repay you for what you've done. And to me, that just, I have no words for that, man. Because sometimes we're really looking for this truth, and I really go to scripture. And I see what God's doing in the world, that he could save a clown, man. I don't know, man, like how it was like God was laughing at me. Because if you see the character that Richie is, man, God bless him, man. Like, he's funny. Like, he dresses like a clown. Like, he's a part of his life has been entertainment. You know, he's a barber and et cetera. But people always blaming themselves, and I don't want you out there blaming yourself. I came here to tell you, he does not deal with us according to our sins, nor repay us according to our iniquities. For as high the heavens are above the earth, so great is a steadfast Lord to those. So great is a steadfast love to those who fear him. Look, man, it's RPL TV. I love y'all. Y'all don't understand why I'm sharing this for you guys, man. Like, I had a moment with God driving in my car. And when I seen this story and seen what Richie the Barber was doing and what he was up to, like, it blew my mind. Like, when I think of the world seeing this guy and how he's always going to be and how he takes on that character. And it's not necessarily wrong, you know? Like, I mean, I don't even think it's wrong. I think, you know, I take that back. Like, it's not wrong. It's just maybe there's, you know, perceptions, reality, you know, and to some people, and I get it. But man, go check them out, man. Read Psalms 103. Thank you guys for being here with me. I want to do longer videos and just spread more love to y'all. But I want y'all to understand, man, don't beat yourself up. Artists, chase what you got to do. Go as hard as you can. Respect people. Make your sacrifices. But don't make mistakes and keep blaming yourself. That's not what we're here for. The future's ahead of us. It's bright. And I'm telling you right now, man, when you look back, it can get real nasty and real dark. And I'm not saying to just put skeletons in your closet and not deal with them. But what I am saying, man, is that God loves you and that he's not judging you. And that strong hand that you need, that almighty hand that you need, God's got you. He loves you. He's there for you because he's not going to repay you for what you've done. He's going to bless you. He's going to take care of you. He's going to guide you. He's gonna, you know, some people right now, like that scripture where it's dark in the woods and all you see is that lantern on the feet. When Psalms talks about lantern on the feet and you're walking with God, you can't see nothing. In the north, the south, the east, you can't see nothing. It's dark, but God has that light right there. Yeah, that's you just with the little 2 feet just moving mad slow. That's you right there. You feel like no one sees you. You feel like you've been working, the pain, the grind, the single moms out there with the kids trying to be a good mother, the inspiration y'all have, people in the gym trying to get right, trying to lose weight. You know what I'm talking about? It's those little baby steps right there. God's going to bless you. I'm telling you, RPL TV, we're here to give y'all the love. His love is steadfast. It's growing for you. He does not repay you for your sins. Go out there, conquer the world. Tell somebody you love them. Tell them God loves them. Hug mom, hug dad. That's what we're doing here at RPL TV. Check out the freestyles, first and the 15th. Music videos, y'all know what's good. Rich Show Productions. Shout out my boy Chris Rose on the ones and twos doing the beats for me. Shout out Trap Cobain, engineering all the songs. First and the 15th. Y'all know what time it is. Bible, love, teachings, encouragement, music, podcast. We do it all here. Peace.